So now let us learn how if metal oxide reacts with acid, what product is obtained. Okay, so now we are taking a metal oxide. When we react this metal oxide with an acid, we obtain the product. We obtain the two different products. Those are salt as well as water. I repeat, when we react metal oxide with an acid, we obtain two different products, that is salt as well as water. By taking a small example, copper oxide, that is CuO, that is copper oxide, reacts with HCl, wherein HCl is hydrochloric acid. Okay, so when copper oxide is reacting with hydrochloric acid, here this copper combines with the Cl. Okay, so it forms copper chloride. I repeat, this copper is combining with this Cl to form copper chloride, plus this hydrogen combines with this oxygen. I repeat, see here, copper is going to form a bond with the Cl and forms CuCl. Here hydrogen is going to form a bond with the oxygen to form H2O, wherein CuCl2 is nothing but copper chloride, and H2O, as you all know, it is a water molecule. So finally we can say that when the reaction of a metal oxide with acid takes place, we obtain salt as well as water. So now let us see an activity, that how acid solution in water conducts electricity. So conducting means generation of electricity. Okay, so let us see now how acid solution conducts electricity. For this experiment, I am going to take four different solutions. One is hydrochloric acid, one is sulfuric acid, one is glucose, and one more is alcohol. So now first let us take one acid, that is the first one, hydrochloric acid. Now let us take hydrochloric acid for our experiment. So now this is a beaker, whatever you can see, this cup, this is a beaker, and now I am going to pour this hydrochloric acid inside this beaker, and whatever this black color thing you can see here, this is a rubber cork. Okay, and there are two nails fixed to the rubber cork. What do you mean by nail? Nail means in Kannada we call it as a mole. Mole hodiyutaralla godege mole adu nail. Okay, so now connect this nail to this rubber cork, and now you have to connect the wires, two different wires, wherein one end of the wire of one nail is connected to the one end of the battery. Whatever the lines you can see here, those are battery. And one more end of the nail is connected to a switch. Whatever the open bracket content you can see, that is a switch. Okay, and to the other end of the switch is connected to a bulb, wherein this is a bulb, and the other end of the bulb is connected to one more end of the battery. I repeat, this is a battery, this is a bulb, and this is switch. So which solution you have poured inside? That is hydrochloric acid. Okay, so hydrochloric acid is poured, wherein two nails are fixed. One nail is connected to one end of the battery and other nail is connected to other end of the battery. Once the wire is connected, immediately what happens? The current starts flowing. Okay, immediately current starts flowing. So how can you say that current is flowing? See, can you see here? Here this is a bulb. Okay, so whenever the current flows and when this current reaches to the bulb, immediately the bulb starts glowing. So if the bulb glows, automatically we can say that because of this hydrochloric acid, the bulb starts glowing, means electricity is generated in this solution. Okay, so similarly, now if I take one more acid, that is sulfuric acid, inside this beaker, here what happens? Again the same experiment. Sulfuric acid is poured, these nails are connected to the battery, again the electricity starts flowing, current starts flowing, immediately again the bulb glows here. Okay, so it means again there will be a conduction of electricity, there will be a generation of electricity. Now let me take the example of glucose and alcohol. So what the difference you can find in hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, glucose and alcohol? That is, these two are acids and these two are bases. Okay, hydrochloric and sulfuric are acids, glucose and alcohols are bases. So when now you take the example of glucose and alcohol here, now if you add glucose in this solution, what happens? Even though you connect these wires to the battery, current will not be generated. Similarly, if you add alcohol here, again the current will not be generated. So why, when you add base solution, why the current is not generating? Because in this base solution, H plus ions are not there. I repeat, in the base solution, H plus ions are missing. They are not there. Wherein only in acid there will be H plus ions. Wherein only in acid there is H plus ion, and this H plus ion helps the current to generate and also helps the bulb to glow. So always keep in remember, to conduct electricity always we require acidic solution. Why acidic solution only is required? Because acidic solution only has H plus ions in it, whereas basic solution don't have H plus ions. So this is a complete activity of acid solution in water conducts electricity. So now let us see how strong are acid or base. Okay, so by looking at acid or base, we cannot just tell that which is strong or which is weak. Okay, so for that, there is a special scale that is called as a pH scale. Okay, so pH scale is used to measure concentration of solution. Okay, which scale? pH scale is used to measure the concentration of solution. So this looks something different. pH, that means pH means, where P stands for potence. Potence means its power. Okay, potence, the word, the meaning of the word potence is power. Wherein potence is a German word. Okay, and the meaning of the word potence is power, where P stands for potence and H stands for hydrogen ion. Okay, so which is the scale? That is pH scale. So pH scale means what? It is a scale used to measure the concentration of solution, wherein in the pH, P stands for potence and H stands for hydrogen ion. Now pH of a neutral solution, so there is a neutral solution. Neutral solution means what? It is a 50-50, 50% of acid, 50% of base. Okay, so such a neutral solution contains 7 value. Okay, in pH it shows the value 7. For which one? Neutral solution. Okay, always remember, the neutral solution's pH value will be always 7. And whichever the solution shows less than 7, that is nothing but acid solution. Okay, neutral solution's pH value is 7, and whichever the solution showing less than 7 value, those solutions are acidic solutions. So now let us see some of the importance of pH value. Wherein pH value, I have already told you, it is a scale of measuring the concentration of a solution. Now let us take the first one. So these are the two main importances of pH, wherein this question might be asked for 1 or 2 marks. So better if you study both the importance. Okay, so now here pH of plants and animals are given, that is that pH value should be between 7 to 7.8. so however, in human's body there will be a acid, similarly inside the plant and animal body again there will be a certain acid content, and that acid content should be between 7 to 7.8. okay, so why we take this amount? Because plant and animal's body are very sensitive in nature compared to animal's body. Okay, so this range shows you that plant and animal's body are very much sensitive, so they undertake this percent of scale, that is 7 to 7.8. so always remember, pH scale of plants and animals is 7 to 7.8. so now the second one is pH change cause in a tooth decay. So tooth decay takes place especially in human beings. So usually we see the advertisements of all our new brands, Colgate, Pepsodent or etc. Everything we can see in advertisement that there will be bleeding gums and automatically there will be teeth falling off from the gums. So why it happens? Because if your tooth consists lower than 5.5 value, actually the pH value of our teeth should be above 5.5. Okay, so if it gets lower below 5.5, what happens? Immediately there will be bleeding gums. Okay, there will be a blood shortage from your teeth and automatically the teeth will fall off. So for the falling off of teeth also there is a requirement of pH scale, wherein pH scale of our teeth should be above 5.5, wherein below if our teeth has a pH value below 5.5, what happens? Then the teeth will fall off. So these two are some of the importance of pH scale. Now let us speak about the salt, common salt. So common salt means what? We usually prepare varieties of food in our home, right? So everything is prepared. If the salt is missing, whether it good taste? No. So the main ingredient for each and every food item, that is common salt. Now for this common salt also, two types of chemicals are used. So chemicals used in common salt, that is, one is hydrofluoric acid and one more is sodium hydroxide. So hydrofluoric acid and sodium hydroxide are added to the common salt for the preparation of common salt. So why these two substances or chemicals are added to common salt? Because to give the whitening color to the salt, that is the one reason, and the other reason is to enhance the iodine content in the salt. Okay, so why specially the elders suggest that salt has to be added to the food? Because salt is the one thing that gives the iodine to a person's body. Okay, so to gain the iodine we require salt. So that iodine is given by these two different particular chemicals, that is hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. And this might be for fill in the blanks, please take it down, that chemicals used in common salt, there are two different chemicals used, one is hydrochloric acid and one more is sodium hydroxide. Now we are coming to a process, that is chloroalkali process. And this chloroalkali process means, here I am taking a beaker, wherein inside the beaker I am placing sodium chloride solution. Okay, when I place sodium chloride solution, what do you mean by sodium chloride? Sodium chloride is nothing but common salt only. Okay, common salt means usually we name it as a common salt, but molecular or scientific name of common salt is nothing but sodium chloride. Okay, now sodium chloride solution we are going to take inside a beaker and we are placing two different plates here. Can you see this plates? One is a cathode plate and one more is anode plate. Okay, now here from these two plates a wire is connected to this box. What is this box? This box is a battery, wherein plus charge and minus charge will be there in this battery. Okay, now here whatever the plate from cathode is connected to positive end of the battery and whatever the plate from anode, it is connected to the negative end of the battery. Once when the wire is completely connected, immediately the electricity will be generated. Okay, so when the electricity is generated, whatever the solution inside it, which solution was there? Sodium chloride solution. When electricity is generated, immediately this sodium chloride will convert and decompose into sodium hydroxide. Always remember, sodium chloride solution is there inside this beaker, and when the electricity is generated, automatically this sodium chloride decompose. Okay, it decompose and form sodium hydroxide. So here which two elements are the main thing? One is sodium chloride and one more is sodium hydroxide. Okay, sodium chloride is decomposing. When it is decomposing? When there is a generation of electricity. So when there is a generation of electricity, this sodium chloride is decomposing and it is going to form sodium hydroxide. So this particular process is called as chloroalkali process. I'll repeat again, sodium chloride solution is going to decompose to form sodium hydroxide. This particular decomposition process is called as chloroalkali process. Knowing what is baking soda and what is washing soda, wherein this is very important question. Okay, so this is the molecular formula of baking soda, that is NaHCO. Okay, NaHCO is a molecular formula of baking soda. Okay, so this will be asked for 1 mark. Take it down. Molecular formula of baking soda is NaHCO, and these are the two different uses of baking soda. So one use is, it is used in cakes, in the preparation of cakes or any bakery items. It is used, that is baking soda is used. Okay, and the next one is, it is used in soda acid fire extinguishers. Have you seen fire extinguishers? Yes, hopefully everybody has seen. So in the preparation of those fire extinguishers, that cylinders and whatever the gaseous content present inside that cylinder, for the preparation of that, baking soda is used in a large amount. Okay, so these are some of the uses of baking soda, and the molecular formula is NaHCO. Now coming to washing soda, here the molecular formula of washing soda is Na2CO3 10H2O. Can you see the dot over here? Okay, that is a dot product, wherein dot product is nothing but multiplication. Okay, you need not put a multiplication symbol, instead of that you need to put a dot. Okay, that is Na2CO3 10H2O, wherein this is a molecular formula of washing soda. And now coming to the uses of washing soda, we have two different uses. One is, it is used to remove the hardness of water. So in water also we can find two different varieties. One is a soft water and one more is a hard water, wherein usually we people will get it now, that is soft water. So when you go to north side and all, you will find the hard water. Okay, so now to remove those hardness of water, we use this soda, that is washing soda. So washing soda is preferably used to remove the hardness of water. And the next point, say, it is used in glass, soap and paper industry. So in the preparation of glass, in the preparation of soap, as well as in the preparation of paper industries, washing soda is used. So these are some of the uses of baking soda as well as washing soda. So this is a very important question. Note it out.